ولكن تحديت الظروف وخضتها وحدي صبورا مستعينا بالصلاة.
كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي، كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أسى محنته، وكم كرهت مصابها.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين ما بعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. دعوة مان، you don't know when to stop, do you, my ignorant friend? Didn't I not let you know, Dawah boy, that any technicality and any screw-ups you make, because remember, refutation, according to you, is a mercy. So take this as a mercy from me, because I always reiterate that it's enough. We have had enough of your neo-Salafi, pseudo-Salafi nonsense. And this time, Daniel Haqiqatjou, I'm going to address the brother later. And to be honest, I've got some words for you as well, to be honest. I'm not very happy with you. But as I said, it's more of a nasiha to you. I appreciate the work you do, but I'll address you at the end. But this is now to highlight the absolute hypocrisy of this ignorant individual by the name of Dawah Boy or Dawah Man. Dawah Man, you know, always attacks Ikhwani Muslimin. As you know, he calls them Ikhwani Muflisin and always warns against them. And as if they're the worst sect that have been ever brought forth, worse than the Khawarij, Mu'tazila, Jahmiya, Jabriya, and Mushabbiha, etc. Now, and he always argued the Ikhwani principle that, you know, we unite upon what we agree on, and we, you know, sort of ignore what we disagree on or what we have differences with. And he calls this an Ikhwani principle. Okay, well, mate, at the end of this video, mate, you're going to be sort of regretting. Well, like they said, you just open your mouth. You're just, you know, the script writers, you know, those on the payroll, they basically give you the script and you just read it, mate. So those script writers, we're going to address you as well, those ustads that you are, you know, who you pay their salary. At the end of the day, they ain't got the bottle, haven't they, to speak against you, to warn against you, or to come out and obviously clarify that this individual, meaning you, you're an ignoramus, mate, and you shouldn't be delivering courses. And another thing as well, this information that's been brought to me regarding a certain little deception that you try to pull. I know it's a couple of months down the line that I've come across this, but don't worry about it, we've got the books here. I will show you that you're such an arrogant, stubborn, super Salafi, safe sex of syndrome carrier that even when it comes to the honor of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where you've indirectly accused him of committing shirk, you didn't want to come out and apologize and admit your mistake and retract, but rather you did a little naughty and you obviously try to play this behind closed doors. But no, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to expose you, son, because you carry a filthy methodology. But back to my video. Yeah, I'm just letting you know what I've got planned for you. So the Ikhwani principle, as I mentioned, that we unite upon what we agree on, and we, you know, disagree, or we sort of ignore what we disagree on, what we have a difference with. And he joined a podcast with Daniel Haqiqatjou, and I'm going to obviously touch on, I'm going to address him as a brother later. Not very happy with him, but we'll obviously mention that at the end. And as you can see on screen, Daniel Haqiqatjou adds a tweet. And he mentioned, when Dawah Man contacted me, he said, I don't agree with some of your positions, and you probably don't agree with all of mine. But we have bigger issues threatening the Iman of the Muslims. We have to work together to address it. He's right. I hope we'll appreciate this mindset. Okay. So, as you obviously just read from Daniel, he was approached by Dawah Man, who contacted him. Now, you know, Dawah Man's a whore for views, isn't it, to be honest? He'll discuss anything and everything, and you could go through his track record. He's just, as I said, he's got his ustads on his payroll, so obviously they won't expose his ignorance. If anything, they'll probably feed it, because they're the script writers, aren't they? But let's now listen to Dawah Man, as I mentioned a few minutes ago, probably a bit longer, regarding that principle that Dawah Man always accuses the Ikhwani Muslimun of. Have a listen.
They know what he believes, brothers and sisters. They know what he believes. I told you, they know what they believe. Yet, they still work with him, deceiving you. Deceiving you. Why? Because of this silly, disgusting principle that they have taken from the Ikhwan Muflisin. We work together what we agree on, and we disregard what we disagree on.
So as you heard Dawah Man, okay, as I explained in my introduction, on the regular attacks against the Ikhwan al-Muslimin, calls them Ikhwan al-Muflisin, says, you know, brought that principle that they hold about, you know, uniting upon what we agree on and disregard what we differ on or have a disagreement on, etc. So he used that as a benchmark, didn't he? And as you've seen in the tweet, as you can see, Daniel Haqiqatjou mentioned that Dawah Man contacted him and said, I don't agree with some of your positions, and you probably don't agree with all of mine, but we have bigger issues threatening the iman of the Muslims, we have to work together, etc. Now what we're going to do is, we're going to show you that, look, you know, when it comes to their master, their spiritual godfather, their spiritual fathers, Saudi Arabia, meaning the leaders of Saudi Arabia, they will go around and disparage you and call you all sorts of names, call you innovators, just because you criticize a tyrant. And, you know, they're based guidance and misguidance in accordance to your devotion to this particular kingdom. Do you understand what I mean? And they've done this throughout the decades. But obviously, we've highlighted the inconsistencies. And as I said, you could go through my page and you could watch it. But he united with Daniel Haqiqatjou, okay? And don't worry, we'll address you as well, Daniel, because as I said, I'm not very, very, very happy with you. But, and again, you know, I'll explain it later, but you'll hear from me. He obviously has an issue with anyone that speaks against his dear rulers or ruler, you know, his spiritual father, the kings of Saudi Arabia. So let's listen to him, and then we'll see if the man who you were uniting with, because you made, you're going to make a very bold statement, and then we're going to play the individual in question, Daniel Haqiqatjou, regarding what he said about your beloved masters. So let's listen to you first.
He brought to our attention something powerful here. He said, this is proof that you can become a khariji based on just your tongue. Forget actually rebelling against the ruler with a sword, which is what you're talking about throughout the video. Just merely just moving your tongue against the ruler, the unjust ruler, is something enough to render you as a khariji.
So as you heard that, man, you know, and this is going back a year, but I'm just showing you that this is why he got involved with me, meaning why he tried to obviously attack me, because I spoke about his beloved spiritual father, you know, MBS and Saudi Arabia, or spiritual grandfathers or spiritual ancestors, you know, because obviously he's Pakistani, he tries to be Arab, but you know, he's, you know, remember, you mate, you're just a Pakistani, all right? I hate to break it to you, but I'm a Pakistani like you, but you know, you're too much into your, you know, love for Saudi Arabia. But anyway, so moving your tongue, okay, so moving your tongue against the ruler, okay, is enough to render you as a khariji. So remember that, okay? So first, you obviously laid out that principle that, you know, the Ikhwan al-Muslimin, that, you know, they disregard, or rather they unite upon what they agree on and disregard what they differ on, or, you know, have, which they have differences on. And then, obviously, now, as you can see, that he made a statement that speaking against the ruler, okay, with just a tongue, would be enough to render you a khariji. So, you know, the individual that you interviewed, okay, Daniel Haqiqatjou. So let's see, listen to dear Daniel, our brother Daniel, speak against the ruler or your spiritual father.
Better for you, to be consistent with your worldview, to move to a country, for example, that is, although it is not perfect. Although
where?
It is
what
not
country?
Ideal,
what country should
is,
I move to?
By Islam.
What country should I move to?
Any country.
Should I move
has
to Saudi Arabia, where they are imprisoning scholars for saying anything in line with the Sharia? If I were in Saudi,
for example, yes.
Right?
Why
are they doing that? Saudi is doing that because of who? The West, right? Because of Israel, okay. Right? Because of America.
What? Is that, well, have I heard you correctly, Daniel? And Dawah Man, did you listen to that? Daniel, brother Daniel, said, shall I move to Saudi Arabia? Obviously, he's discussing having a debate with the apostate prophet, Apus, as my brother Higeb likes to say. So, brother Daniel said, shall I move to Saudi Arabia where they imprison the scholars for speaking in line with the Sharia, and mention that Saudi Arabia do this because of Israel and the West, criticizing the rulers publicly, criticizing the rulers. So let's listen to brother Daniel.
Better for you, to be consistent with your worldview, to move to a country, for example, that is, although it is not perfect. Although
where?
It is
what
not
country?
Ideal,
what country should
is,
I move to?
By Islam.
What country should I move to?
Any country.
Should I move
has
to Saudi Arabia, where they are imprisoning scholars for saying anything in line with the Sharia? If I were in Saudi,
for example, yes.
Right? Why are they doing that? Saudi is doing that because of who? The West, right? Because of Israel, okay. Right? Because of America.
Like brother Daniel says, Roy. So now I ask you, Dawah Man or Dawah Boy, you Ikhwani, you were warning against this principle, and You reached out to Brother Daniel, okay? Now, Daniel should have known better to sit next to or even give time or clout to a super Salafi, a box-headed super Salafi, neo-Salafi like you. You're not a Madkhali, but to be honest, you're no different, to be honest. You're when it comes to Khuruj and your paymasters, or not even paymasters, you do it for free. You just like licking boots, don't you? But, you know, united licking boots, like you said about Ikhwan al-Muslimin, that they unite upon or with others who they disagree with because... they obviously have this principle. You unite with other Salafis, even if you disagree with them, because you like the taste of the Saudi boots. That's what it is, isn't it? So, subhanAllah al-Azim, now you've just exposed yourself as a mere hypocrite. Because Daniel, our brother Daniel, criticized Saudi Arabia publicly. To who? To even a murtad, to an atheist. Criticized them publicly. Probably the video's got thousands of views. Everyone's seen it. Most people seen it who watched it. So he criticized Saudi Arabia. He said they imprison scholars who are in line with the Sharia. So what he's saying is that Saudi Arabia are not in line with the Sharia. And they do this because of America and Israel. So you, okay, let's put that tweet back up. Daniel said, when Dawah Man contacted me, he said, I don't agree with some of your positions. And you probably don't agree with all of mine. Obviously, because Dawah Man and obviously Daniel Haqiqatjou are complete opposites, aren't they? One's a bootlicker, the other one's criticizing the rulers. How does that happen? It's like Dawah Man, you know, let's make sense of this. It's like me joining your panel. It's like me, you offering me to have a conversation with you or have a discussion with you regarding saving people's iman. Because the greater good, isn't it? Obviously, saving people's iman is a greater good. So you wouldn't have any issue uniting with me, even though I wouldn't unite with a bootlicker like you. But anyway, just say hypothetically in a hypothetical world, you know what I mean? In a hypothetical world, somewhere in Mars or Pluto or Jupiter somewhere. So would you unite with me? Huh? Would you unite with me? So you said anyone that speaks against the rule with this tongue is a Khariji. So you united with a Khariji. According to you, obviously I don't believe it. You know what I mean? You bootlickers have your principles all over the place. So your ustad, you know who you pay, you know who you pay their salary, who can't, who ain't man enough, who ain't got the cojones to refute you publicly, because obviously it's like biting the hand that feeds you. You understand what I mean? And you guys are a disgrace. All of you on the payroll are a disgrace. I'm going to show you later on, Dawah Man. You know what I mean? I'm going to show you exactly how deceptive you are. And you might have had this ijtihad. Remember that ijtihad that you had with the imma, you know, the mujtahideen that leaked Yasir Qadi's email? And I'm still waiting on who that guy is. I know who he is, but you know what I mean? That individual, we want to hear it from your mouth. You're happy to release those emails because you had those immat and mujtahideen with you, subhanAllah al-Azim, that released those emails. So, you know, I bet you obviously spoke to your mujtahideen imma that obviously told you to do what we're going to show later. You know, that way you disrespected the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And you know you have, because what you did is you cut out that part. I'm not going to show you, son. We're going to show you everything, my bootlicking friend. So, what we have gathered now, okay, what we have gathered from what we presented is that Dawah Man's an Ikhwani. Okay? So Spobs were right. Spobs are right about you. You're an Ikhwani. If we go by your, you know, bootlicking principle, because you're only bootleggers unite, aren't you? You know, you sing Kumbaya. You know, sorry, Kumbaya for the ruler. So, you know, all you bootlickers, you know, have your little cat fights in between. But Spobs are right. The Madkhalis are right. You're an Ikhwani, bro. You're an Ikhwani. You understand? So don't, you know, come out with this nonsense, because you are a certified Ikhwani. Okay? So, Dawah Man, hang your head in shame, son. You've let yourself down. So what we'll do is we'll play those two videos back where you make that claim, you know, with the tongue. So that claim, we're going to play that. And then we're going to play Daniel's video just so that, you know, people are aware of your Ikhwani tendencies. Okay, let's have a listen.
He brought to our attention something powerful here. He said, this is proof that you can become a Khariji based on just your tongue. Forget actually rebelling against the ruler with a sword, which is what you're talking about throughout the video. Just merely moving your tongue against the ruler, the unjust ruler, is something enough to...
Better for you, to be consistent with your worldview, to move to a country, for example, that is, although it is not perfect...
Where? What country? Ideal, what country should I move to?
That is ruled by Islam.
What country should I move to?
Any country...
Should I move to Saudi Arabia, where they are imprisoning scholars for saying anything in line with the Sharia? If I were in Saudi,
for example, yes.
Right? Why are they doing that? Saudi is doing that because of who? The West, right? Because of Israel, right? Because of America.
Now, about 6 months ago, Dawah Man did a video, as you can see on screen, and the video is called The Mysterious Wahhabi Book. And it's about an hour long. And in this particular video, he made some shocking statements. Subhanallah al-Azim, he made some real shocking statements. And I addressed it and obviously, you know, presented, I think it was about 25 minutes. And if you haven't watched it, go check it out. Obviously, I'll explain it in brief in this video as well. But it's very, very comprehensive in the other video. So I'll put that in the description box and you can watch it as well. So what Dawah Man did was he uttered some absolute atrocious statements. And again, his script writers, the one he pays the salaries to, you know, those ustads who ain't got no bottle, who ain't got no cojones, you know, they, obviously they can't bite the hand that feeds them. And I keep saying it, those ustads, you know, those so-called students of yours or students of knowledge should be ashamed of themselves. But they might have been involved in this deception as well. But, you know, probably are. I can't put it past them because they ain't got no bottle, have they? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play an extract from this video, okay? I'm going to play an extract from this video. And what you'll notice is there's a cut in the video, okay? There's a cut in the video. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to play back my video 6 months ago, and I'm going to show you that Dawah Man knows he made a massive error, but because he's arrogant and because he has a bunch of yes men, meaning those ustad, those students of knowledge who are on the payroll, they must have, you know, got together and said, oh no, because he watched my video, obviously, hence why he cut it out. So it's clear to see that he is an absolute idiot. And he has no love for the Prophet ﷺ because he indirectly accused the Prophet ﷺ of shit. But let's have a listen to him first.
The graves and what you do is very strict. The Sharia is so strict. You can't add, you can't take. It has to be out of Sintur. Because from it, shirk comes. When people die, you follow the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ in how to deal with the dead. Because from it, shirk comes. From it, shirk, it manifests. Does that make sense? So you've got to take things in accordance to how the person did it. So that was the fourth part of the book, the reason why the children of Adam fell into kufr. The fifth part.
So you heard that, man, from 40. So what you could do is I'm going to put that video as well in the description box as well. I'm going to put my video that I did 6 months ago. So from 45 minutes and 4 seconds, he starts talking about the graves and how severe it is and how strict it is. And all the way up until 45 minutes and 29 seconds, okay, he speaks about, you know, why you shouldn't call upon other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how dangerous it is, etc. And then it cuts off, okay? It cuts off. Now, this video has clearly been modified from the original video, which was recorded about 8 months ago or 9 months ago. I think I recorded mine about 6-7 months ago. Now, what happened? Why did he cut that out? Because I listened to it and I spotted a huge mistake to the point that he accused the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam indirectly of committing shirk. And I've got the books here. I'm going to go through it again to show you that you tried it. So. And I've got brothers watching your videos. It's not just me. I've got brothers watching your videos. May Allah preserve those brothers who are watching your videos. Subhanallah. And they come back to me and they report back to me. So they watch that video because I needed something from it. And they go, Hajji, you know that video you did 6 months ago, 7 months ago? That part that you found and you exposed him on is not even there no more. And I said, what? I said, you sure? They go, Hajji, watch it. So I watched that clip, okay? And I noticed there was an extract missing. Okay, now my video, for some reason, my Adobe Premiere wasn't synchronizing with that, the extract, the clip that I cut out. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to present to you what I cut out, okay? Okay, what I cut out, and you listen to me for about 10, 15 seconds. I'll play to show you that this video was 6 months ago. And you will see the atrocious comments that he makes, and we'll make a comment on it. Let's have a listen. So without going into further details, let's listen to Dawah Man himself basically utter some absolute nonsensical statements which would leave you shocked to your core. Let's have a listen.
When people die, you follow the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ in how to deal with the dead, because from it, shirk comes. From it, shirk, it manifests. Does that make sense? So you've got to take things in accordance to how the Prophet did it. When we're sad, we put our pictures of those who die. When we're sad, we go to their graves. Why is the problem? Because when you go to the grave, what are you going to do? People who talk to the dead. This is shirk billahi azza wa jal. You go to the grave and you start saying, I miss you. Allah, I wish you were here. No matter your grief and your pain and your sadness, you are talking to the dead. And talking to the dead is dua. Dua means to talk, to call. And you cannot make dua to the dead. This is shirk billahi azza wa jal. Anyway, he goes on and he explains it.
Now, as you heard Dawah Man state that those who pass away, it is incumbent on us to follow the sunnah when one passes away and not to fall into shirk, and which is correct. That statement is correct. Then he uttered a statement which really makes the heart skip a beat. He said that anyone that talks to the dead, that is shirk. So as you heard, I played back 6, 7, 8 months ago when I took that extract, it had the whole statement from Dawah where he said talking to the dead is shirk, you see, and talking is dua, absolute nonsense. We're going to go into it to show you now that you've indirectly accused the Prophet of shirk, hence why you took that part out. So you watch my video because it's quite unique for you to take that part out, just that extra from our video. So you and your team, if it was you, then you got to fear Allah Azza wa Jal and you got to make tawbah because you've accused the Prophet of committing shirk and we're going to present it. So you said, where it cuts off in your original video, which is the mysterious Wahhabi book, it's going to be in the description. You said you have to take it in accordance to how the Prophet ﷺ did it. Or as you said, okay, I'm not quoting you verbatim, but something along those lines. And at 45 minutes, 29 seconds and 30 seconds, it cuts off. Where my video continues on, because I took the extract from your original video, and you said talking to the dead is shirk, and you're talking is dua. Ridiculous, absolute nonsense. But you extracted that out from your original video. Now, why did you do that? Why didn't you just own up and admit that you made a massive blunder? Why didn't you face? Why didn't you just come out and repent? Because you do not love the Prophet ﷺ. You love your Saudi rulers more than you love the Prophet ﷺ. Because if you had any adl, if you had any nadam, if you had any regret, you would have come out and you would have publicly apologized for those statements, or you would have retracted them. You would have said, that was out of order, it's incorrect, talking to the dead is not shit, etc. But no, you're a stubborn super Salafi, bootlicker, and indirectly you've accused the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam of committing shit. Now let's present it. You think I'm joking? Talking to the dead is shirk. Let's play that back.
When people die, you follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in how to deal with the dead, because from it shirk comes. From it shirk, it manifests. Does that make sense? So you've got to take things in accordance to how the Prophet did it. When we're sad, we put our pictures of those who die. When we're sad, we go to their graves. Why is the problem? Because when you go to the grave, what are you going to do? People who talk to the dead. This is shirk billahi azza wa jal. You go to the grave and you start saying, I miss you. Allah, I wish you were here. No matter your grief and your pain and your sadness, you are talking to the dead. And talking to the dead is dua. Dua means to talk, to call. And you cannot make dua to the dead. This is shirk billahi azza wa jal. Maybe he goes on and explains.
Now, I don't know why it wasn't synchronizing with the original cut. It's something to do with my Adobe Premiere. It must have been an issue at that time. But, you know, you can see it's in full from when Dawah Man mentioned those statements all the way to the end. You see? And Dawah Man cut it out from the video that he re-uploaded. I don't know how he done it, but he cut it out. SubhanAllah. Now, you accuse the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of committing shirk. Okay? You've accused him of shirk. Let's present it. As you can see in my hand, I've got Sahih Muslim. I did this 7, 8 months ago, by the way. And I'm going to put the original video in my clip. You heard me speak, you know, I was wearing the shemach. That was 7, 8 months ago, or 6, 7, 8 months ago. But yet, you didn't come out and apologize. And don't worry, Daniel, I'm going to address you as well, my brother. Don't worry about it. We're just going to show you that you, Daniel, you let yourself down, man. I'm not happy. How dare you? If you think yaqeen and this Americanized Islam is evil and needs to be refuted, then my brother, these Madakhila super Salafis are just as bad, and you went on their platform. If you don't know about them, Akhi, then you need to get behind the desk and study. With all due respect to you, Akhi. With all due respect, if you don't even know this and you're just fixated with Umar Suleiman and his likes and his cronies, etc., then that shows, Akhi, you haven't studied, bro. You have not studied. If you joined Dawah Man after all these cock-ups, I'm going to show you the tweets underneath that clarify that, you know what, you messed up, mate. And I'm going to address you as well, but let me just get to this. As you can see on screen, okay, I'm just going to paste it because I want to address my brother Daniel. We got hadith number, okay, 974. And it mentions that Aisha radiallahu anha said that the Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would go out towards the Baqi' at the end of the night. And when he got to Al-Baqi', okay, remember he said talking to the dead is shirk. When he got to Baqi', he said, what? As-salamu alaykum dara qawmin mu'mineen. So again, this is salam. No problem. We can give you that. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَأَتَاكُمْ مَا تُوَعَدُونَ غَدًا مُؤَجِّلُونَ وَإِنَّ إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهِ بِكُمْ لَاحِقُونَ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, peace be upon you, adobe of the believers, meaning those who are believers. So that's salam. What you were promised would come to you tomorrow. وَأَتَاكُمْ مَا تُوَعَدُونَ غَدًا مُؤَجِّلُونَ وَإِنْشَاءَ اللَّهِ بِكُمْ لَاحِقُونَ. And you are receiving it after some delay. So just to clarify, he's talking to the inhabitants of Al-Baqi'. And remember, it's not just one grave. Numerous Sahabas are buried there. So the Prophet is talking to a group of Sahaba, radiallahu anhu. So has the Prophet committed shirk now? Because as you can see from the translation, what you were promised would come to you tomorrow. So he's talking to them. He's talking to them. And then he says, and inshallah we will join you. Wow. This is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talking to those at Baqi'. He was talking to them. So indirectly you've accused the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of committing shirk. How dare you not make tawbah? How dare you not come out and make a clarification or repent publicly? Because you know what? You love the Saudi rulers and you love this state more than you love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fact. Why did you cut it out? Why did you cut it out? Huh? Tell me, why did you cut it out? Why didn't you just come out and leave it there or remove the whole video? Because at the end of the day, you messed up. So if due to the honor of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you should just say, you know what? I messed up. You know, may Allah forgive me. Khalas, akhi. Khalas. Everyone makes mistakes. Not mistakes such as this, because you're an absolute fool, you bootlicker. You're an absolute idiot with a tongue. But this is the point. Let's back this up even further. We got Riyadu Salihin. And as you can see, he mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is Buraida radiallahu anhu. He mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to teach them whenever they came out to visit the graveyard. And he said the same dua. And as you can see, the same thing. That what came to you tomorrow has come to pass. And you will receive it after some delay. And we shall join you inshallah. So there you go. So you've accused the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam committing shirk. So where's your tawbah? Why do you take that part out? Huh? Why do you take that part out? Let's back this up even further. Let's make it brief because it's a lengthy hadith. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, when the Prophet passed away, came, uncovered his face, kissed him, and said, "Bi abi anta wa ummi, tibta hayyan wa mayyitan." You are beautiful or good in while you are alive and in death. Walladhi nafsi bi yadihi, and whose soul is in Allah's hand. Allah will never make you test death twice. So now I ask you a question. Did Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu speak to the dead? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. He was dead. So did Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu commit shirk as well? So I did this 7-8 months ago. And then I quoted passages from Adwa al-Bayan. Or Adwa al-Bayan by Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanghiti, rahmatullah alayh. And I also took passages from there and I told you what his statements were. But yet, you're an arrogant. So either, less now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. When you watched my video, because you watched it, you only took that part out. So you definitely watched my video, you freak. Okay? Because this is the honor of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Shamsi dishonored the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you dishonored him. So now it's your turn to come out publicly and apologize. Because you're a disgrace, mate. And your ustads, those students of knowledge that you have around you who are on the payroll, disgrace to you as well. Aib alaykum. Disgrace to all of you. Because you guys defend him. Or not even defend him. You guys don't even publicly come out and refute him because he pays your bloody salary. So you can't refute him, can you? Because you're on the payroll. Now I want to address Brother Daniel as a brother. Uqsumu billahi al-azim. I'm very disappointed in you. Because look, akhi, let's be fair. When it comes to this back and forth with Yaqeen, again, as far as what, you know, your over-exaggerations as they've claimed, akhi, I haven't really looked into it and I can't really comment. But if there's a scale of haqq and batil in this regard, akhi, you're clearly on the haqq on this. Wallah al-Azim, you're clearly on the haqq. But let's be fair, akhi. You're a blind person could even figure out Umar Suleiman is completely off track and off the rails. So what you're doing is, again, I don't know what's going on in the States, but really you're the voice of haqq there. But it's not as if it's something spectacular, akhi. Umar Suleiman and his, you know, Americanized Islam and, you know, watering down Islam, akhi, anyone can do it. Let's be honest, akhi. If this problem was in the UK, akhi, I'll be tackling it. Let's be honest. So, if you can't differentiate, and again, we're not saying that Yaqeen and this, you know, what they're trying to promote is dangerous. It's very dangerous, akhi. But if you can't see the dangers of Super Salafiyah or the Madkhali-esque sort of mentality, and you don't know nothing about Dawah Man and his filthy methodology, then, akhi, you really need to wake up. And once again, akhi, let's be honest, let's be fair, let's call a spade for spade. When it comes to Yaqeen's articles, akhi, when they're misquoting, you know, classical scholarly works, you haven't really dabbled on that. Because let's be fair, akhi, you don't really, look at me, akhi. You go through my videos. The Madakhil and the Super Salafis, I've done 10 hours worth of research, akhi, or 10 hours worth of videos responding to the dads, going to the classical books, every misquotation that they've tried to pull from the books, akhi, I've counted it. Now, have you done that? Have you got into the articles of Yaqeen and then grab the classical books and put it on screen and show the distortions? No, akhi. Because let's be fair, you're only stating the obvious with Umar Suleiman. You're just stating the obvious, akhi. Let's be fair. You're doing a great job, akhi. May Allah preserve you, and you know, you're doing an amazing job. But if you can't see the difference, what I'm saying, akhi, I'm not saying they're the same, but they're very dangerous. The Madkhali Super Salafi mentality is a problem and needs to be tackled. But you voluntarily went and had a podcast with Dawah Man, who's an absolute ignoramus, as I just proved in this video. And this is what I've done 7-8 months ago, and I've been consistently refuting their methodology. So if you don't know about this, akhi, so there's two musibas right about now. One is that you don't even know about it, meaning this Salafi, Neo-Salafi, Pseudo-Salafi, or Salad fees, like one brother keeps saying, Salad fees. Salad fees, not Salafi, Salad fees. Then it's a musibah, akhi. Then really and truly, akhi, your obsession and your fascination with Umar Suleiman, you need to take a step back, akhi, and refute their articles now. We know that Umar Suleiman is misguided and he needs to be refuted. We get it. Now you need to dwell in the articles and highlight their inconsistencies in their misquotations. And many brothers have done it, but you haven't. Because let's be honest, akhi, if you've got the credentials and you've got the tools to actually access classical works, or you have a library, or if you don't have a library, then access to PDFs, do some research. Do the proper hard, do the groundwork. Now is the time to show us what you really are about. But unfortunately, my dear brother, for you to join Dawah Man's panel, and he even mentioned stuff about, you know, Asha'ira and stuff. Like, I'm not an Ashari, I'm an Athari, let's put it that way. But you stayed silent, akhi. And I'll show you a post of yours that you made a few years ago that you were upon one wave. So are you in agreement with Dawah Man in this regard? Let's have a listen.
يتبعون أهواءهم that no Muhammad Sallam, if they don't Salam listen to you, then they're following their yeah. desires. Meaning anyone who disobeys the Prophet Sallam is following their desires. So Salaf would use this term. So because of their bid'ah, and the bid'ah evolves, it started off with something small. Let's unite with the Shia. Let's unite with the Ash'aris. Let's do that. But then it evolves. You think, oh, it's not going to go far. No.
And you stayed silent. Okay. Now again, I believe, from the da'ira of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, that the Asha'ira are part of it. The Asha'ira are part of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Obviously, I disagree with them. They're not upon the manager self when it comes to Asma wa Sifat. I'll say that clearly. But you can't kick them out of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah and put them in the same brackets as the Jahmiya and the Mu'tazila, because they're Ahl al-Bid'ah. Asha'ira Ahl al-Bid'ah, according to this rhetoric. You stayed silent. And what's worse is, as you can see on screen, you said, Ustad Imran, Dawah Man. Akhi, are you, now, no offense, akhi, is Dawah Man an Ustad? Akhi, this is the joke of the century. If you see him as an Ustad, akhi, then to be honest, whatever institute you've got, Al-Lasna Institute, and I don't know where you got Al-Lasna from, like, it's not institute, I don't know where that doesn't make sense. But how can you teach or even have an institute, akhi, when you consider Dawah Man to be an Ustad? Hashalillah, akhi, this is aib. This is a joke, bro. Absolute joke. Now let's play. Let's put on your Facebook post. And you attended a conference of Yasir Qadi. I think it was the days where you were Pali Pali. And you said, Sheikh Yasir Qadi gave a lecture at the AMJ conference on bridging the so-called Salafi Ashari divide. His overall point extended beyond just this divide and gave a model for intra-Muslim and multi-faith interaction and activism regarding intra-Muslim differences and intra-Sunni conflict. So he basically, you carry on, you say his main point was not that we should divide. And then you mentioned, look at this, he said, you mentioned ultimately for intra-Sunni relations, there is so much more that we have in common than not. So we should look for that commonality and not look for reasons to split. We should also respect the scholarly roots of these two traditions, Salafism and Asharism, really Atharism, both of which can be traced to the early century of Islam. So hold on here, my dear brother. Dawah Man uttered what he uttered about the Ash'ara. You stayed quiet. Now, again, we have this split, and it's been going on for centuries. Major scholars were Ashari, akhi, and we take their works. We don't call them al-bid'ah. And this is what they say, oh, they were affected, and, you know, they were predominant. So they're predominant here. If anything, the Ash'ara are the majority, you know, if we go by numbers. So you can't use that excuse. So why did you stay silent? Why? My brother Sajid Lippa, may Allah preserve you, you know, may Allah preserve you and, you know, grant you a long life and bless you. You know, when Dawah Man was invited to your podcast, you didn't press him. You allowed him to utter his nonsense. Akhi, you guys, again, especially you, Sajid, you were a student of knowledge. You should have put it on him. Again, I know you're kind of your, you know, genuine, calm, nice, you know, sweet brother. So I understand. I give you a pass, Akhi. But you, Daniel, you're the person that's quite, you know, straightforward. You should have said, unfortunately, I disagree with you, and had a back and forth. You can't allow Dawah Man to dictate. This is a problem with you people. You know, you get fascinated. He's an absolute fool. He's an absolute ignoramus. He has no knowledge. He gets scripted. The ustads that he pays, the one that's, you know, enrolled in his knowledge college, the one who he pays his salary to, who ain't got the backbone and the testicular fortitude to, you know, refute him. Now, are you going to refute him now after what he did with his video with about cutting that part out where he accused the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam of shirk? Are you going to come out and refute him now? To all of you Salafis who are not spubs, I know you attack spubs and they deserve to be refuted. But where is your love for the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Where's your love for the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Huh? Because you, let's be honest, the King of Saudi Arabia, if we said anything about him, you would have been in droves refuting me. I've done a video against Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, Rahmatullah Alayhi, regarding his takfiri tendencies. I got part 3 to come. So all of you, don't worry, that's coming as well, to show you that he's a forefather of ISIS. But don't worry, we'll explain that. You all come to the rush. I got articles here, I got this person making a video, etc. You see, now we see how much love you have for the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But just to show you, Brother Daniel, that a lot of people are not happy with you, including me, even though I'm with you with this yaqeen back and forth. I'm agreeing with you. You're upon the haqq on this. But let's show you how other people have said in your Twitter post to show you that, honestly, my dear brother, you call him Ustad. It beggars belief. It's just, I can't even put it into words. You let yourself down. That's all I can say. But as you can see in the tweets, we've got a brother here that writes, the madakhila, again, it's neo-madkhalism. What I mean by that? The madakhila, but really it's not madakhila, it's super salafiyah. But because the madkhali are predominant, they put Dawah Man in the same bracket, which to a certain extent he is, but he's not a madkhali, but you could say he has the traits. It says the madkhali is equal of an enemy to Islam, if not more than the heretics and zanadiqa of yaqeen. Look at that. I didn't expect this from you, to be honest. Just sad. Look at that. There you go. It's also another brother. You have to be careful from the madkhali mindset. This is what the word I was looking for, madkhali mindset. They are the biggest fitna who support the rulers no matter what. How can he be concerned about USA and not utter the single word against UAE and Bahrain? There you go, another one. Then he says, I really hope that DH, meaning you, is not one of them. I hope you're not. Because put it this way, if you're against yaqeen and you're not against super salafiyah or this madkhali mindset, then akhi, I can't support you. I'll be honest with you. He did a good job with yaqeen, but the madkhalis are not better. You see? Another one, he has defended, this story about Dawah Man, or Dawah Boy. He has defended Al-Madkhali in one of his videos, though. And he extensively promotes this notion that we should obey rulers no matter what. Now, you criticize Saudi Arabia. So that shows that you are not upon this wavelength that you got to listen and obey the ruler no matter what. Even if he commits Hitler-like massacres, Mussolini. Go check my playlist. If you haven't watched it, you may not have. But you need to go watch it. So if you're the type of person that because you ain't getting no support in the States and you thought, you know what, I'll just jump, you know, Dawah Man supporting me. Dawah Man just is a whore for views. So he just got you on. Prior to that, he had someone else on. You know, he'll have whoever that, you know, can give him views. But reality is, Umar Suleiman's a target. You know, this neo-Salafi. I'm against Umar Suleiman. I'm against Yasser Qadhi, for crying out loud. I did a video against him. But I don't do it at the backdrop of this neo-Salafi mindset. And to a message to you, my brother Daniel. I'll address Dawah Man in his payroll with studs after you. Look, I got a lot of love and respect for you. Wallah al-Azim, you know, you're standing up to this, you know, wave of these deviants of yaqeen, and you're doing a splendid job. May Allah preserve you. But akhi, if you cannot differentiate between yaqeen, and I'm saying yaqeen obviously are evil, but if you cannot see the dangers and the evils and the mindset of this super Salafi, neo-Salafi, you may even subscribe to it, akhi, and if you do, I can't support you. Then I cannot stress enough that you have no business in tackling these matters. You have no business. If you can't differentiate between the two, if it's a vendetta against Umar Suleiman, if it's personal, then again, that's between you and your Lord. But what I can say to you, Akhi, is this. Believe me, Akhi, if this phenomenon was in the UK, I'll be tackling it. I'm dealing with the Madkhali, the Super Salafi, the Shia, etc. I haven't got enough time to go through these articles. And if this phenomenon did eventually show this ugly face in the UK, believe me, there's plenty of ulama and students of knowledge that will tackle it, and I'll be assisting them. You know, I'll take the back seat and let the students of knowledge and the ulama deal with that. And even myself, I don't even classify myself as a student of knowledge, but believe you me, Akhi, if I was in the States right now, and I was dealing with your phenomenon, I'll be going through all of those articles by those payroll yaqeen instructors and going through all of the footnotes and reading through it, akhi, and refuting them. Looking at the discrepancies and finding any issues, technicalities, misquotations, and misrepresentations. Akhi, and I'll be doing videos like I've been doing against Dawah Man and Shamsi and the Madkhalis and their ilk, which have, you know, sprung up their ugly heads trying to attack me and refute me over the past year and a half. But if I come across harsh, akhi, I'm just being, this is how I am. I speak my mind. And لا يخافون لوم التلائم. I don't fear the blame of the blamers. So that's my message to you, my dear brother. You know, if I've come across rude or disrespectful, I apologize. But I'm passionate, you know, I can't stand people who obviously have, well, I would say slight hypocrisy, because if yaqeen's a problem, then Dawah's not a problem, and yet you call him an ustad, akhi, fi nadar, wa fihi nadar, should I say. Now, to Dawah Man, it's clear now that you've disrespected the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by accusing him of shirk, okay? Now, you try to take that extract out. 7 months, 8 months later, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exposed you again. If you've got love for the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just come out and retract and apologize and seek tawbah for your deceit. Now to the payroll ustads, that just keep silent because can't bite the hand that feeds you. Once again, I've presented the evidences yet again. Okay, my video will be in the description box. If you want to go see it in an extensive manner, you could go watch that as well. It's incumbent on you now to either disassociate yourself from this freak and his knowledge college, or you are going to be held accountable for being a Hizbi and dishonoring the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam by staying silent. It's incumbent on you. Khalas, enough's enough. I've let this slide for 7-8 months. It's not him. He's a freak. You push him forward. It's you guys who are behind the scenes that are promoting him or even giving him the script to utter his nonsense. And I got another one to do where he basically became a mufassir overnight and he explained a verse which none of the mufassirun have explained it. But yet, you guys don't say anything because he's got the, you know, publicity, he's got the popularity, he's got the views. You guys are just pushing your agenda. So obviously he utters the nonsense that you send him, and whoever you may be, whoever you may be. I know who you are. I know who you guys are. He's mentioned your names more than once. It's you guys that promote him. If you guys need to disassociate from him, if I'm being honest, you guys need to dissociate from this freak. Okay? Dissociate from him. Or warn against him publicly. Remember the qa'ida. If any evil is done in public, it needs to be refuted in public. He's dishonored the Prophet ﷺ publicly. It's incumbent on you to refute him in public. So that's it for this particular video. Quick one. In and out. Short and sweet. Snappy. So I think the next video will be the Ibn Arabi video. I got plenty of scripts. Walillahi alhamdu minna. We're in a blessed place. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us and keep us humble and you know, allow us to spread the haq to the best of our ability and to guide us and to forgive our sins and to educate the believers so that they can, you know, avoid these hizbis and these super Salafis and these Madkhalis and these Shia and these progressives and follow the middle path. And that's what we strive to follow. So look after yourselves, make dua for me. Wa sallu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أساه حتى وكم كرهت مصابها لكن رأيت الخير يسكب في أنا كم مرة قد ذقت من عظم البلاء بشر وشيطان يحاصرني أبا كم مرة قد أظلم الدرب ضحى وتحدر الدمع وضاقت بي رؤى كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أساه حتى وكم كرهت